Welcome to Coding with Seth. Today we're going to be recreating this bouncing ball animation here using frame of motion and React. Let's get into it. We'll start off with the animation project we've been using. First, we're going to create a new component, bouncing ball. We need to import React. And we're going to create a new component. Let's start by returning an empty div. Now we're going to import that new component into our app.js file. Let's add our new component to our grid. First, we need to set up the container. We'll set the dimensions and set it to display flex. Now we can't see anything at the moment, so let's add another element. This time we'll render a circle within our container. Let's draw this on the screen by adding ball style. We're going to set it to display block. Give it a width and height of 1 rem. And set the background color to black. We're also going to round the edges, so it's a circle. And there we go, it's rendered in the center of the square. Now to add animation. The first step, as always, is to import motion from frame of motion. Secondly, we'll transform our span into motion.span. Now we can start animating the ball. We're going to add the transition, called bounce transition. This object will contain the transition for the y-axis. We'll set a duration to 0.4. That's roughly the right amount of time that we need to make it bounce. We'll set yo-yo to infinity, which means once it gets to the end of the animation, it will reverse the animation. And we're also going to set the easing to ease out. This will give it a bounce rather than a smooth up and down motion. Now we're going to set two keyframes. To do that, we just pass an array to the Y value in our animate. We set the first value to 100% and the second value to negative 100%. This completes our bouncing animation. Now, how about we change the color when it bounces? We'll add another two keyframes to our background color. And we'll add some cool colors here. We've got a pink and a purple. We can see it transitions through the colors smoothly, which is not really what we want. It also only plays once. Let's go back up to our bounce transition and set our duration to 0 because we want it to be instantaneous. We'll also set yo-yo to infinity, just as before, because we want it to continue to play. We'll set the easing to ease out. We'll change the repeat delay to twice the duration of our Y animation. Now, as it bounces, the color changes, and that completes our animation. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this short video tutorial useful. And if you'd like to see more, then please subscribe. Also, if you have any suggestions, leave a comment down below. This is Coding with Seth. Until next time. Thank you.